Hello and welcome to another video from DFFML. Today we will be talking about saving and loading models. We can do this in two ways. We can save a model in a directory and we can save a model as an archive. I would walk you through both of these methods and show you the differences between the two. So let's get started. First, we'll go ahead and import all the necessary modules. Then we will build our dataset for training. In DFFML, we have this very nice cache download function, which is idempotent in nature. Then we'll go ahead and load our dataset into memory. Now let's split our data into train and test sets. So now we are going to instantiate a model and define all our features. Here I have set the location as a folder. If there's no extension in the location, it would be inferred as a folder. Let's go ahead and train our model. So let's go ahead and take a look at our model folder, which has all the necessary files to restore our model properly. So we have this joblib file, which actually contains our model. To test the reproducibility, we can go ahead and check the accuracy before and after loading the model from the saved state on disk. So currently we can see we have an accuracy of 0.4968 from the model in our memory, and then we would restart the kernel to make sure that our results are reproducible. And as we can see, we have the exact same accuracy from our loaded model as well. Now let's go ahead and change the model location to an archive. Let's change it to scikit-rc.zip. And we need to make the same change down below, where we would be verifying that our model is properly loaded. Let's go ahead and restart the kernel. Alright, so let's rerun all of the cells and see how the model is saved as an archive. As you can see, a scikit-rc zip has been created. And we get the accuracy of 0.4906. And let's go ahead and see if that is the case with the loaded model as well. Yes, we get the same accuracy here as well from the zip file. So there is a slight difference between the two methods. Let's go ahead and take a look. So if we go ahead and take a look at the scikit folder one, we only have the scikit-json and the joblib file, which is the saved model on our disk. If we go ahead and take a look at our zip file, we also have a config.json. So this is the same config that you passed while instantiating the model. So for better reproducibility, I would recommend you go ahead and use the archives, because they also store the config. Now let's go ahead and try another archive format. Now I'd be using .tar.gz. We need to make the same change down here so that we load the correct model. And let's go ahead and train our model. Instantiate and training has begun. We have started training, and we can see that the tartar cheesy has appeared here. The accuracy from our in-memory model is 0.4562. Let's restart the kernel and reload the model from our tar.gz archive as well. And as we can see, we have achieved the same accuracy after loading the model as well. Now let's go ahead and talk about config.json. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at the differences between the two methods of saving and loading. On the left, I have the folder. And on the right side, I have both the archives open. So as you can see, the scikit-features.joblib file is common among all the three. So this is the same. The only difference you would see is that we have a config.json in both of the archive file and it's not saved here. So when we export a model in an archive, we save the config which was used to instantiate the model. This contains the hyperparameters and other features and all the information that was used to instantiate the model. So this is a recommended method for better reproducibility. If we take a look at the config.json, we can see all the information that we passed to the model while instantiating it. Same file is there in the zip file as well. I hope this helps and gives you a better understanding on how to save and load models in DFFML. If you have any questions or issues, please feel free to open an issue on our GitHub repository intel/dffml.